Alright.
So who's the director?
Alright. Sonia, please. Alright, so
Quiet, man.
When they said we just build the confessional. So basically, I confess my last name to you is about this guy that gets
restart because I'm
alright.
Okay,
so
hold on. And
delicious coffee.
Delicious thing.
It's like coffee within coffee.
Coffee session.
Yeah. Alright, so when they said off, I confess my last name to you. I'm the director from Camera Follow, and this is my co-director, DP, and all of the above, Fernando Ferdosa. So we just finished building the stupid confessional, and what you're about to see right now is kind of like a commercial of how I want the movie to be, or kind of like this guy who gets he goes into this confessional, and then he goes and he challenges his priest to confessing like his most atrocious sin.
Yeah, it's cool because you know it's a role reversal type thing where you know he comes in and the priest is the one that's put on the spot instead of you know the other way around. Because every time you go into a confessional, for those of you that are religious, you go in there and you have to pretty much open yourself completely up to a stranger.
How do you know that you're not religious?
Because I the point is, you go in there and you know you open yourself up. You say the worst things that you've done to this person that supposedly has the power to absolve you. And in the movie, you know, the roles get reversed, and the confessee is the one that has all the power.
And one of the things that actually reverses it is that the priest, basically goes on the other side of the confessional.
Complete role reversal in any way that you see it. You know, even the physical spots are reversed.
Yeah, so we actually tried, in the end we're gonna burn the confessional. We're not supposed to say anything about water. I mean,
in the end, we built a miniature.
Yeah, and
to burn it.
We burned it with lighter fluid and we kind of had trouble burning it. Oh, yeah. Almost burning Zagro. But I think, you know, we have already the technique of how to do it. So this is the commercial for... I confess my last name to you.
Enjoy.
Enjoy it. Enjoy it with the enjoyment.
Enjoyception.
Enjoyception.
Okay. No, we'll edit.
I do it. And that's kind of fucked up. You wanna say? You know, like take two.
How's it going?
What up?
My name is Fernando Ferdosa. This is our view of the day.
Setception.
We are in the director of When the Magic Happens, a story about a kid who thinks he's got magic power. Sometimes I think I'm pretty magical.
Awesome. Magic with magic.
Magic stuff. You know, the hardest part I think for me in the movie I think is gonna be creating the. It's supposed to be a comedy.
How you know like Harry Potter fans really are to an extreme that they think they're in the role itself, and then they think that the whole world.
Yes.
Are in it. And the kind of the twist of the movie, you could say, so it was a pretty funny twist, is that you have this guy, you know, thinking he's all, you know, magical and stuff, and then he's being like seen by this doctor who also thinks he's magical.
Sometimes I think I'm pretty magical.
It's actually Dark Evil Voices.
And it's also, it's everything that in the movies and in the books the author was not allowed to say. Somebody came to you and they're saying that, you know, they have magic, that they're magical. Sometimes I think I'm pretty magical. Stuff like that. You wouldn't react like, oh, there's this world and all this stuff. You would, you know, you would curse, and if somebody tried to attack you, you would get it.
Come to you and say that you're magical, and then you think, or you are magical yourself, are you gonna get...
What's gonna happen then?
What's gonna happen, bro?
And that's what the thing is about, but it's
you
also...
Guys, you guys are gonna fight each other once.
The main point of thing is it's kind of a story of, the whole general theme is a story of acceptance, you know? Because, you know, there's this kid, his family doesn't believe him, they put him into this mental asylum, you know, no one believes him, he's in there by himself, they don't treat him very well, and he doesn't care if they, you know, somebody likes him, or if they, you know, want to be his friends or what. He just wants at least one person to believe him and believe that he does have these powers. And then the only person that he has a chance with is this doctor, who turns out to be just completely insane, and he's the one that should be in the
Yeah.
The mentor.
And in a way, he, you know, even though he believes he has power, he doesn't believe the kid. Which makes it kind of ironic within the irony itself.
Ironyception. What you're gonna see now is the preview to my movie, When the Magic Happens.
Cheers.
Cheers.
You had to forgive yourself before the Lord can forgive you some.
I'm not here for redemption.
Then what are you here for?
What are you doing this?
Everyone's got their secret, Padres. Are you willing to die for yours? Your choice, Padre. 3, 2.
Okay. Dime tus pecados, dime.
It's a good answer, Shuka.
I can do those things.
Ha 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 ha.